In this video, we can discuss about pharmacology of broad spectrum antibiotics. Here, we will discuss the definition, classifications of broad spectrum, both tetracycline and chloramphenicol, mechanism of action, adverse drug reaction, and uses and applications of broad spectrum antibiotics. What is broad spectrum antibiotics? These are antibiotics which have a broad spectrum of activity towards different types of microorganism, like both gram positive as well as gram negative microorganism. There are two important classification of broad spectrum antibiotic: tetracycline and chloramphenicol, and they will act the they will produce their bacteriostatic action by inhibiting protein synthesis. In case of tetracycline, they will bind with the 30S ribosome subunit, and in case of chloramphenicol, they will bind with the 50S ribosome subunit. So that is the two classification of broad spectrum antibiotic. These classifications are further reclassified into some groups. Now let's start with the tetracycline. What is tetracycline? As the name indicates, these are the antibiotics which are having a nucleus of four cyclic ring, and these are broad spectrum antibiotics. They are active against both gram positive and gram negative cocci as well as bacillus type of microorganism. Now tetracycline is again classified into tetracycline, oxytetracycline, doxycycline, minocycline, demiclocycline, and glycine and tigriglycine. And here this I have mentioned here the different half life of this tetracycline. Tetracycline have an half life of 6 to 10 hours, oxytetracycline 6 to 10 hours, doxycycline 18 to 24 hour, minocycline 18 to 24 hour, demiclocycline 16 to 18 hours. So as the half life increases, we can reduce the dosing interval. And we can take, so for example, doxycycline, we have to take only one dose per day, like that. Now, what is the mechanism of action of tetracycline? It will inhibit the protein synthesis by binding with the 30S ribosome. Thereby, it will prevent the synthesis of protein, and thereby it will inhibit the growth of microorganisms. So it will produce a bacteriostatic effects. Now coming to the spectrum of tetracycline, as we mentioned before, this is a broad spectrum antibiotics. So it will inhibit practically all the type of pathogenic microorganism except fungi and virus. So we can use for the treatment of any kind of disease which are caused by the microorganism except fungi and virus, and all the positive and negative, gram positive and gram negative cocci were originally sensitive. Most of the gram-positive bacillus like Clostridia and other anaerobes, Listeria and Cornibacterium are sensitive to tetracycline. It can be inhibited by tetracycline can inhibit spirochetes, actinomycetes and rickettsia also. Now coming to the pharmacokinetics. When consider the pharmacokinetics of tetracycline, we have to note some important points, because tetracycline should not be given with the any food material or any other substances which will form an unabsorbable complex with the calcium or other metals. So we should not give tetracycline along with the milk, iron preparation, non-systemic antacid, sucralfate, etc., because it will reduce their absorption by forming an insoluble, unabsorbable complex with the calcium and other metals in the other preparations. So it is better to take in empty stomach so that the absorption will be more if you are taking in empty stomach. And the capsule should be taken half an hour or 2 hours after the food. That is the usual advice that we have to give to the patient who are taking tetracycline. It should not take with the food. If we are taking, it should be after 2 hours or half an hour before the food. So that is the pharmacokinetics of tetracycline. Now coming to the adverse drug reactions of tetracycline, as we mentioned, tetracycline is a broad spectrum antibiotic. Even though it is a broad spectrum antibiotic, it have loads of adverse drug reaction in dose related manner. So it can produce different organ toxicity in different organ, like liver damages. It may cause fatty infiltration of liver, and it may produce jaundice in case of liver, and it may cause kidney damage. It is a risk only in the presence of existing kidney disease, except doxycycline. Doxycycline do not have any effect on kidney, and it may produce some phototoxic effect, a sunburn like or other skin reactions on exposure to part is in some individuals. So we have to advise the patient to that we should not contact with the sunlight after taking tetracycline. And in case of teeth and bone, calcium tetracycline chelate get deposited in developing teeth and bone, and so it may lead to discoloration of the teeth. That is another important adverse drug reaction of tetracycline. While taking tetracycline, the teeth may get discolored due to the deposition of calcium tetracycline chelate. Now it have some anabolic effects, like it will reduce the protein synthesis, and all overall catabolic effect can be reduced. Now it may produce some irritative effect, so it can cause epigastric pain, nausea, vomiting and diarrhea on oral ingestion. It may increase intracranial pressure, it may cause diabetic insipidus, some vestibular toxicity. Minocycline may cause ataxia, vertigo, nystagmus and subside when drug is discontinued. Then it may produce some hypersensitivity reaction like rashes, urticaria, glossitis, pruritus, etc. It may cause super infection due to the marked suppression of resident flora. Now coming to the contraindication, tetracycline should not be used during the pregnancy and lactation, and also in children. It should be avoided in patients who are taking diuretics, because the blood urea may get rise in such patients. Preparation should never be used beyond their expiry date. Should not be mixed with the injectable tetracycline with other antibiotic like penicillin. Inactivation or chemical antagonism may occur. Do not inject tetracycline intrathecally. Doxycycline has more lipophilic nature. They are highly potent, so it may cause severe adverse drug reactions. It should not given with the milk, and it should not given with the antacids. So these are some contraindications of tetracycline. Now coming to the uses of tetracycline. Tetracycline is used as a first choice of drug for several diseases like venereal diseases, atypical pneumonia, brucellosis, cholera, plaque, relapsing fever and rickettsial infection. And tetracycline is used as a second choice of drug in case of anthrax and tetanus, along with the penicillin and ampicillin. And second choice of drug for gonorrhea and azithromycin to pneumonia. Now other conditions can be covered by using tetracycline, like urinary tract infection, acne and COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disorder. So these are the different uses of tetracycline. So this is the one of the effect of broad spectrum antibiotic. So if you are taking this for some kind of fever, it will alter the entire echo natural flora of the intestinal tract, and so it may produce some diarrhea condition. So that is another disadvantage of broad spectrum antibiotic. Now coming to another broad spectrum antibiotic, that is chloramphenicol. It is broad spectrum antibiotic which is obtained from Streptomyces venusillae, and the mechanism of action is same as that of tetracycline, but there is a change in binding with the ribosome subunit. It will bind with the 50S subunit of the ribosome, and it will inhibit the protein synthesis, and high dose will inhibit the mammalian mitochondria also. So it will be affect the protein synthesis in mammalian, and so if you are taking in higher dose, so it will bind with the 50S subunit of ribosome, and thereby it will inhibit the synthesis of protein. Thereby it will produce a bacteriostatic effect in different microorganisms. Now coming to the spectrum, Chloramphenicol is primarily a bacteriostatic, but if you are taking higher concentration, it will produce a bactericidal effect on some bacteria like Haemophila influenza and Neisseria meningitidis. This is a broad spectrum antibiotic which is against nearly all the range of microorganism, gram positive, gram negative, cocci, rickettsia, as that of tetracycline. It have broad spectrum of action. Now coming to adverse drug reactions of chloramphenicol, it may produce severe adverse drug reactions like bone marrow depression. So what will happen is it will reduces the immune response, both antibody mediated as well as cell mediated immune response will be suppressed. So there will be a chance for more infection by some other kind of microorganism. Now hypersensitivity reactions like rashes, fever, atrophic glossitis and angioedema, and there is a super infection due to the suppression of normal flora of the GI tract. So there is a chance for super infection, and it may produce some irritative effect, and it may produce nausea, vomiting, diarrhea and pain on injection. And the most important adverse drug reaction that is usually seen as an objective type of question or multiple MCQ question is the gray baby syndrome. This is the specific adverse drug reaction of chloramphenicol. So if you are administering chloramphenicol to a newborn, it is the inability of newborn to adequately metabolize and excrete the chloramphenicol. So what will happen? The color of the body baby will be changed to gray. So it should not be used in baby newborns. So because it has baby has inability to metabolize the chloramphenicol, so the color of the baby may be changed to gray. That's why it is known as gray baby syndrome. So that is an important adverse drug reactions of chloramphenicol. Now coming to drug interaction, since the chloramphenicol is an enzyme inhibitor, it will decrease the metabolism of different drugs like tolbutamide, chlorpropamide, warfarin, cyclophosphamide, which are used concurrently with the chloramphenicol. Thereby, it will produce the systemic or it will increases the plasma concentration of these drugs, and it may lead to toxicity with this kind of drugs. And we have to give special precaution while using chloramphenicol. It should not be used for the minor infections, and it should be avoided for the repeated course, and daily dose should not exceed 2 to 3 gram. So that are the precaution to be taken while using chloramphenicol. Now what are the uses of chloramphenicol? It can be used for the treatment of enteric fever, pyogenic meningitis, anaerobic infections, intraocular infections, and in urinary tract infection, Brucella, rickettsia, whooping cough, and second in whooping cough, we are using chloramphenicol as a second line choice of drug. Now, in chloramphenicol is available as some liquid form in order to apply in eye for the intraocular infections. Chloramphenicol, some kind of capsule shaped preparations are available as ready to apply in the infection. And the most important thing is the chloramphenicol cannot be used for the treatment of typhoid. Except all condition we can use the chloramphenicol. So this is another interesting troll by Troll KMC. Chloramphenicol cannot be used for typhoid. We can use for any kind of other infections. So that is all about the definition, classification of broad spectrum both tetracycline and chloramphenicol, mechanism of action of tetracycline and chloramphenicol, adverse drug reactions and application or uses of different broad spectrum antibiotics. Hope it is clear. Thank you for watching this video.